because of the stand that he took for the gospel. Oh, praise the Lord. He was hated by men. He was hated by church leaders. He was hated. But one thing I like about our chief apostle, he never watered down the gospel for money. Or he never compromised for popularity. He stands flat-footed and let the world know one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. He did not compromise because he was not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, because it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believed it. And I believe that we have believers all over Great Refuge Temple here today. And praise God, you should have some joy. There's one thing with our chief apostle, he didn't like no drum service. He didn't like for us to sit up in church and after we have a funeral or something here. I want you all to open your mouth and I want you to say something there. I want you to give him praise. We'll give him some of the praise, but give him all the praise. And don't you know somebody in this service or ongoing, and the chief will want us to celebrate. There's nothing to be sad about here today. I cannot preach his funeral, he preaches his own funeral. Okay, so he did that himself. Nobody can preach that. Amen. But in that evening to his homegoing service today, don't you sit up in here, don't dry yourself looking at me. Go ahead and pray the Lord of God. It's a leadership that I have to do. Somebody should have a praise of your heart. Somebody should have a praise of your lips. Somebody should be running down the aisle. The Lord, I thank you. Lord, you know you wouldn't have been able to sit up in this church today cold in your right mind if it wasn't for the power of the Holy Ghost. You didn't keep yourself with your good-looking self. You didn't put out there. It wasn't your education that kept you. Oh, praise the Lord. Somebody can say right now. So Reverend, tell me all this. You can hold the organ right now. And somebody else in this church, you can hold the drum right now. You don't need to play the organ to work up my emotion. You don't need to play the drum to work up my emotion. But when I think, Chief out of it, going home. But chief of pastor one. Some choking up and going home. Some of you didn't want to release him. But he said to me a few days ago in the hospital, he said, son, I'm ready. Amen. I'm ready to be offered. The time of my departure is at hand. And he looked at me and smiled. He said, I have fought. Could have heard a few years ago in the hospital. He said, I have fought a good fight. Amen. I have finished my course. Oh, praise the Lord. Amen. It's over. My work is over. And I, last but not least, he said, I have kept the faith. And Mount Keeper and all of his friends that are here today, all of you can say, my God. My God, he kept the faith and fought a good fight. He did not take down for nothing. If you sin in his presence, he'll stop you right there and say, wait a minute here. And he'll correct you right then. And he said, now I fought a good fight. Now henceforth they're laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day. Oh, somebody should praise the Lord. I believe in that. I believe you in this story. It was a man. He sat down and he says, I need somebody to take this package for me beyond the river. And present it unto the king. Oh, glory. Young man walked in and said, I'll make the journey for you. The young man took the package and threw it under his arm and started out towards the king to deliver. The first thing he met was the rough road. He made it through the rough road. But after a while, and by and by, he met the storm of life. The storm rocked him from side to side. The storm rocked him, and he said, you know what? I can't make the journey. I know I promised, but I can't make it. And he turned around and went back home and had the package to the old man. With tears in his eyes, he said, oh, I wish I could just get one person to go beyond the river and deliver this package. A middle-aged man walked in and said, I'll take the journey for you. The middle-aged man took the package, threw it under his arm, and sure enough, he made it through the rough road. He made it through the high winds, and he made it pretty well. But then that young man, middle-aged man, he got to the mountain. He looked at the mountain. He said, mountain, you are a little bit too high for me. And then he made a attempt to climb up that mountain. Amen. But every time he tried to get a foothold, he couldn't make it. So, the middle-aged man turned and went back home. And he said, oh man, I tried. I make it over the rough roads. I make it through the highway, the storm of life. But oh, when I got to the high mountain, the mountain too high for me.
Come on, sir.
And he said, I cannot make the journey. But after all, an old man walked in. And the old man said, sir, I'll take the package beyond the river and I will give it to the king. Well, praise the Lord. And then the first thing the old man did, he stopped and he caught up the cross. And then the second thing he did, he stooped down and he tied up his sandals and he tied up real tight. And the first thing he met was the rough road. And he made it over the rough road. And the second thing he made it to, and then the storm of life. If sometime you can meet some storm in this life, it will rock you from side to side. Amen. But he said, go, wind, go. But I made a promise that I'll make the journey. And he made it to the storm of life. Amen. You watched the old man, his hair was silver from the cares of his life.